They are not. The magic of Jesus believes in your grace and your presence. Thank you, happy day. Deliver in the magic of Jesus Christ. Every attack around the world, every form of witchcraft and sorcery, every spirit, every enchantment, be broken.
The Lord is our life and our salvation.
And I would like to name Jesus and the anointing of healing in the labor of himself. He said that you are going to work and I was feeding the Lord, feeding us the Lord. But we know that the devil is alive. Somebody said, the devil is alive. Somebody help me sing that song tonight. The devil is alive.
Hallelujah.
The devil is alive. Thank you. that you will. The man, and I said, you got to be part of the world, is able to finish. What he has started in you is that he will finish. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He said, he will look into him. The enemy will try many times to cause you to take your eyes off him and to look at what he is trying. What he is doing and when he will attack you. But the Lord said that what he wants, but the Lord said what he desires is for you to keep looking at him, keep looking at his promise, keep looking at the areas he will heal and deliver and strengthen, keep looking at what he has promised, for he is faithful to provide, he is faithful to deliver, he is faithful to do what he has promised. In the mighty name of Jesus, as our eyes remain single upon you, I see, Lord, reject the noise of this world and the words of men, but to trust in you with all of our strength. And as you keep our eyes on you,
are only destroyed and broken and cut.
when faith increases. See, many of us have been woke up from thinking we have enough faith. You can never have enough faith to face the challenges that Satan is our way. That's why when you read Romans chapter 1, the Bible says we've got to go from faith to faith. We've got to face each challenge in our life with a different degree of faith. We've got to increase faith. Amen. And to do so, we got to feel ourselves the word of God. And we got to go into fasting and praying. As a season, we got to go on into fasting and praying for our love, our family, our finances, our children. Amen. So we got to keep that mindset and be having the crusade and seek God and believe God. Amen. Amen. And so this is something we got to go in weekly for practice. We want to get leads of serious fasting for certain deliverance in the body of Christ. Simply break, because hell is enlarging itself and Satan forces and kingdoms are increasing. So it is. We got the increase and Christ got the increase in us. Christ in us, the hope. Remember when Jesus told Peter, he said, I pray that your faith will not fail you, but the devil desires to shake you like wheat. And the devil wants to shake God's people like wheat. He wants to destroy our mission. He wants to destroy the work of God in the world. And we've got to keep pressing in. Father, touch our hearts. I receive new strength, as you stand and hear for our daughters, our children, our sons. Touch them, yes, cry, and then deliver us to flow in the mighty name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus, release Jesus. So on this Saturday, we are praying for the covering for our family as the Holy Spirit has lead them and instructed me in the mighty truth. Yes, Father, we want strength as well as there's a new name and strain form of incredible interruption of the world, and there's increasing deaths in America and all these places. And then because it's not a world, we're not letting people know, we're not letting people know, we want to stay tuned to the news and we don't want to hear things about it. Then you see how red eyes spread. Different types of books and Bibles, amen. And as you understand, we are living in a time, it doesn't take much to kill somebody to die, amen. And so it is in somebody. We've got to stay under the blood of Jesus. We've got to stay focused. I don't tell you to fear the devil, we shouldn't fear the devil, the name of the devil, but we should stay close to God. We should fear God. The secret of the Lord for them now fear the King. Amen? He said, my people are destroyed by lack of knowledge. It's even all the reason why people have knowledge. Jesus with more strength in the blood of Jesus.
Thank you.
name of Jesus, the anointing of healing and deliverance. Whatever is not of God, their water, their blood, their food, come, Christ around in the spiritual water of earth. And it will be a blessing in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We're going to prepare next to pick up this evening tithes and offering. Father, by the power of the Holy Ghost, the mighty name of Jesus Christ, your grace, your blessing, your anointing, pray in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, thank you, Lord, for your precious blood. Heal upon the house by a word of the Lord. And when she's visited the doctor, when she wake up in the morning as she walk, she must see your healing power. She was still rich by a word of you, the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Today, let's prepare for much more fasting. In this year, we want to dedicate ourselves to fasting and prayer. Amen. Do not, amen, do not lose your desire for prayer and your excitement of prayer. Come on, somebody. And you don't have a desire to fast, but pray to get in your word. It shows that your faith is the best. Your what? It speaks the best. Because faith is alive in you. Faith, it is what you have. Come on, somebody. You will be, if you look at our daily life, you know, God has strength and joy to do everything. To work, to feed our household, to provide, to amen, to whatever we enjoy, whether we are strong, we're gonna get it done. Amen, somebody. And what does it last for 10 years of your life? It's time in the world, it's our relationship with God, it's the house of God. And we can be committed to God and make it a priority. Come on, somebody. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Amen. The moment we make our prayer life an option, our fasting life an option, studying the word an option, attending the house of God an option. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Then you have made God an option in your life. Because these are ways we stay connected to God. I want you to understand, that is the way that God has designed to stay connected to Him and to stay in fellowship with Him. Come on, somebody. Amen, somebody. Because you don't see God physically. See, it's not like your wife, your husband, or your neighbor, your amen, your cousin that you can see and you can visit and you can talk to. And you can have a relationship with them. These are the ways we maintain our relationship. And when we really make an option in our life, when we do try to help, we will find it doesn't pay. Or we take the time to do. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Amen. You understand what I'm telling you tonight? Not only that, you are setting an example for your generation. For the young children that are growing up in the world. You are setting an example. When they see praying, they will understand the importance of prayer. But if you're telling them about prayer, tell them to understand the importance of prayer. When you tell them about reading their Bible and they don't see you do it, they don't understand the importance of it. Come on, somebody. Amen, somebody. Amen. Amen. Hey, they come and talk to you about the problem and you tell them about attending the church and they see you bear their pain. They don't see the reason to go. Remember that. Amen. Amen. Do not make what God has deemed in connection with Him. Yeah, amen. The greatest connection is in your personal relationship with the Lord. You cannot neglect your rest. Amen, somebody. Father, we thank you. Remember what that every demon in hell that try to afflict them, touch them, and bring sickness and disease against their life, to their dreams, anywhere they are seated at the table of their enemies, be broken, be destroyed, be shattered, be pulled down. The mighty name of Jesus. Every point that you might have been to the table of the head, give it fair. You can't have my scores. We root it out of the power of the power of Jesus Christ. For the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church of Jesus Christ. Come on, be loose, be loose, be loose, be free. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive Christ the anointing.
Amen. And I'm so glad I designed it for security.
might not get the job, it might be in the water promotion, it might be in the water, less than $1,000. The first thing the Spirit of God asks me to happen, do you tithe? Most of the time, I'm going to be no. So even though I pray with you, amen, somebody, and believe God for you, amen, somebody, you ought to be obedient to the word of God. This is my obedience as the word of God. And you will find that scripture in Hebrews chapter 7. The reason I go to the New Testament, because there are people in this time that claim that that's Old Testament. But go to the New Testament, you see, Peter was taught by James, was taught by all the apostles. Amen, somebody. A matter of fact, the apostle Paul in Romans 12 made it a ministry. He said that by itself is a ministry. Amen, somebody. It's not only your tithe, it's also helping the poor. Helping those who are not needy. Visiting those who are in the prison. Those that need clothes, shoes, and all those different things. Amen, somebody. Amen, somebody. Those that are homeless, those that are is called the ministry of what? Giving, meeting the necessity of the things. Amen. So spiritually, you can fast and pray and become a spiritual person. Amen, somebody. Having salvation. But in your physical life, you can struggle. Financially, you can struggle.